Hey guys, it's me, Drew, and I'm here to bring you my empties. I finished a whole bunch of crap. Once this bin gets full, this bag, I know it is time for another empties video. Then I also have a pretty exciting Diptyque announcement that I think you guys are really going to like at the end of this video. So, the first thing that I finished, speaking of Diptyque, were their three holiday candles from 2016. I know, I finished all three of them, which is, I'm gonna put this down, which is crazy. And the first one that I finished was the Le Sapin, which was like a Christmas tree. It's very, very yummy. I burned this one in my bedroom because it was my favorite one out of all three. It's perfect. I mean, it had a little bit of citrus in there, which made that Christmas tree scent just pop. It was really, really pretty. I loved it so much. This blue one, the incense, let me tell you, this is the strongest candle I've burned in a while. It was like, wow. I had this in my living room, in on the mantle, and it just, it perfumed the entire downstairs, and it smelled like just a smoky scent, but it had this warmth to it. It was really, really yummy. And then my least favorite one, I burned this in the kitchen. It was the one with the gingerbread man on it. It was like gingerbread and honey. It's called Delicious Spices. It was okay burning. It was definitely a kitchen scent. Like, I couldn't see burning this in a bedroom or a living room. Maybe a living room, but kitchen was perfect because it did smell like Christmas spices. And now that these jars are all cleaned out, I'm going to put them back in their boxes and stick them in with the Christmas stuff, and then put them out for decoration next year, like put maybe tea lights or something in there. And as you can see right here, I'm burning a candle. I'm actually burning Bay, which is such a good candle. So in here, the first product that I have that I finished up was a Jo Malone Wood Sage and Sea Salt Body and Hand Wash. These little guys last forever. Let me just tell you, I had this in my powder room upstairs. I love the scent of Wood Sage and Sea Salt. It's the only Jo Malone fragrance that has no florals in it, which is really exciting. It's really, really cool. Very fresh. I love this scent as a cologne, but I love the scent as a hand wash as well. So putting this up in my bathroom was really, really nice. It was very refreshing, especially in the coolness of the winter. It just brought that little bit of summer and like spring to my house. Another hand wash, the Aesop Reverence Aromatic Hand Wash. This is the one with the vetiver, pettigran, and bergamot, which is exfoliating. My favorite hand wash by far. This guy, I believe, is $40. This is $40 as well. This is 8.5 ounces. This is 16.9, so it's almost double for the same price. I love these hand washes. I have like 5 backups. You'll see a lot of empties of these. I have about half of one going now in the powder room, so this is my new hand wash of choice. Every time I go to New York, I always stock up on some. I just can't get enough of them. I love them. I finished a Senorita Margarita Shower Gel from Philosophy. My favorite scent from Philosophy for shower gel, because it's like a margarita. It smells super fresh, super citrus, but it has that saltiness in there too, which just really makes it like pop in the shower. And it's a bright green color. I love looking at this when I'm in the shower. I finished a cleanser from Lush, Bouche de Noël Face and Body Cleanser. I really, really liked this. It was very, very sweet, like a cookie. It had some cranberries in it, really good antioxidant. I got a giant pot of it. I shouldn't have got the big pot because I didn't use it. I don't use it every single day, so it like started to go bad. But then I ended up using it as a body scrub, like when it had like a week left on the expiration date. That was amazing. I love this stuff on my body, kind of more than my face, even though I did like it on my face. But on my body, this stuff outperformed. It was so good. Made my skin feel super soft. I finished the big, big tub, 12-ounce tub of the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream. For some reason, my hands got super inflamed at work, like maybe like coming home from work. And I'm thinking it's because like being in water all the time and being around, like, washing your hands so often, my hands just got super chapped. So I would, like, leave this in my car and slather my hands on this on the way home, and it repaired them. Like, it made my hands, it was a lifesaver for the winter. I really, really liked this. Then I finished, this is a month of shower gels. This I just recently finished. This is the L'Occitane Fresh Verbena Shower Gel. This was cooling. It had like little beads that bursted in it. I love the way that this smelled. I got the shower gel, the lotion, and the perfume in like a set whenever it first came out. This was a while ago. My goal is to not buy any new shower gels. I did treat myself to the Gypsy Water Shower Gel from Byredo, but I'm not buying any shower gels. I have so many. This was really, really nice. So I've been working on finishing those up. And all of these, you'll see a ton of them, and you're like, how did he finish these by the last Empties video? This literally had like half of it left, so. I finished a Brazil Nut Shower Cream from the Body Shop. This was like completely unscented, which was kind of a bummer. I don't know, I just didn't like it. It was whatever. It didn't lather that well either. Another one that sucked. The Josie Maran Argan Cleansing Oil for the Body. This stuff was terrible. It didn't lather. Like, I mean, it's an oil, but like the almond shower oil from L'Occitane, which I'm surprised they don't have one of those in here. I go through that like it's going out of business. I thought that this would be like that, and it wasn't. It didn't glide on the skin. It just didn't do anything. Like, it just sat on there, and like it was so hard to like get all over your body. I did not like that. I finished a Simple Sugars, which is a local Pittsburgh girl, in strawberry, and this is nice. I use this every single day when I used it. It lasted only like 2 weeks because I used, not even, maybe a week, because I used a ton of it every single day, but super, super nourishing, and it smells like true strawberries. It's not an artificial strawberry scent. I really like it. And it left like the oily residue on your skin, but it was really, really hydrating. I finished, oh, there looks like there's a teeny bit left. I finished I Love Juicy Shampoo from Lush. As you can see, I put a shit ton of product in my hair, and I need to get it out at the end of the day or in the morning because I don't take a shower at night. And this stuff gets in there, the pineapple, papaya, kiwi, mango juices. They really just like get through that oil and really, really clean your hair. I really like this stuff. I finished the jojoba oil moisturizing shower gel from Crabtree and Evelyn. Didn't care for this. The scent reeked. It was so bad. It was just, it was a nice like shower gel like consistency, but the scent I just couldn't handle. I finished another hand wash from Jo Malone. It is the Blackberry and Bay. Again, love the formulation, love the fragrances. This was the first fragrance that I ever purchased from Jo Malone, which is interesting. I finished not one, but two Martians from Sunday Riley. I love this stuff so much. Like, there's literally, there's like nothing left. And this is in an airtight pump, so it goes up as you use it. This, there's like the tiniest bit left. I love this product so much. I love the smell. I use like half of a pump all over my face after I clean my face. It's mattifying, but it's not like typical when you think mattifying, you think that it's going to be like tight on your skin. It's not. It leaves your skin super hydrated. It has cucumber in there too. It has an aloe, I think, too. Bentonite clay, marshmallow. So I really like this. This, especially after I shave, I really like this. It just really cools your skin too. So I'm working on another one as well. It's my favorite toner of all time. Definitely never, ever, ever want to be without my Martian. Getting to the end, I finished a Kate Somerville Nourish Moisturizer. I really love her moisturizers. I like her moisturizers mainly because they have an airtight pump. So you literally go like that, and it pumps out exactly how much you need and just swipe off the top. It's non-bacterial, which is awesome. I never buy a moisturizer that is in a pot, that like in a tub, that does not have, like, if it has any antioxidants in there, especially antioxidants. Antioxidants are antioxidation for the skin. But, whoops, my computer went to sleep on me. Hopefully it's still recording. Are you guys still there? Yeah, you are. Okay, so anyway, and if you have something that has oxygen in there and you're opening it up, well, oxygen's hitting it, and that's the benefits aren't as well. So look for moisturizer if it's in a tub that does not have antioxidants. The Belief brand, which is at Sephora, their True Cream Moisturizing Balm is really, really good, and it's affordable. But this stuff from Kate Somerville is amazing. It just, like, glides on the skin, leaves your skin hydrated but not oily. They also have an oil-free one, which is really nice. Oh, another part of the green line from Sunday Riley is the UFO Ultra Clarifying Face Oil. There is nothing left in this pot. Like, you cannot even get anything left. I'm working on another one. I have another one. People were either hit and miss with this product, I found. I really like it. Just being honest, I prefer Artemis in a way. I used Artemis. I still have like half of a bottle. I don't want to use it up, but I am. I've been using this in the morning and Artemis at night so I can use it up. Artemis is a thicker, more viscous oil. They discontinued that because this had better technology or whatever. This goes in like that. It has salicylic acid in it, which kind of sucks because like Sunday Riley's really like a green company. Now, sure, they're a green beauty, but they do have regular science. They're like science-based. Well, they're plants and science where they are needed, like botanicals backed up by science or something like that. Their CEO, by the way, sucks. Like, I returned it. I hated it so much. It just, like, it was sticky. And it also was in vitamin C, which vitamin C is super unstable, and it wasn't in an airtight container, so it didn't really make me that comfortable using it. But this stuff is really, really good. It goes in a snap. I finished a deodorant, the Schmitz Natural Deodorant. I really like this brand of deodorant. This is Ylang Ylang and Calendula. I'm using the Rose and Vanilla right now, but I really, really like these deodorants. Another deodorant is the Piper Y Charcoal Deodorant. I loved what this did for me. Wasn't too keen on the smell, and I hate that it's in a jar. The Schmitz is available in a jar, too. I don't like it because it's, like, sticky, and then you gotta rub it under your arms, and I'm just not into that. I finished the Party Light Scent Plus Melts Citrus Peel and Sage. These I use in my downstairs because my dad smokes, and I want to get rid of all that smell. So I use Tart Warmers downstairs. He likes these. He liked the smell. It's very, very strong, very citrusy. I finished a Bath & Body Works hand soap, Snow Kiss Citrus. This was my last Bath & Body Works hand soap. I use this in the kitchen because I wash my hands more often than not in the kitchen. Like, well, more often in the kitchen than anywhere else. So, these were okay. The foaming soaps are very drying, in my opinion. I finished a La Mer Eye Concentrate. This was a free gift with purchase when I purchased my Creme de la Mer, which I'm on the fence on. I want to try the moisturizing gel cream, but this stuff was really, really nice under the eyes. I have another. I got two of these when I purchased, so I'm working on another one now. I finished a sample of the Aesop Reverence, which is the same scent as the hand wash hand balm. I really, really, really liked it. I ended up purchasing it, and it's in like a squeezy tube. It is in my bathroom upstairs next to the hand wash. I finished a Molten Brown Patchouli and Saffron body wash, which is really, really yummy. I use these as a one-time use bubble bath. I finished a Byredo Gypsy Water sample and a Byredo Rose of No Man's Land perfume sample. As you know, I purchased the Rose of No Man's Land. It is right up here. I'm going to do a room tour too, but they're right up there, my four burritos that I have, which I love. And Gypsy Water, I really do like. I want to purchase it, but it's so everybody has it. I don't know. And then the last four products are Glossier. I finished the Glossier Super Pure Serum. I really, really like this. I need to order another one. It is niacinamide and zinc serum. It really, really helped. I mixed 2 to 3 drops, depending on the day, with my Glossier Primi Moisturizer, which I also finished. I have a new one. I have the rich one, too. But this, I mixed these together, and it really helped keep my skin clear. I would cleanse, tone with Martian. I would, like, cleanse. I'm using the Murad Clarifying Cleanser, UFO. Then I would let that sit, and I would blow dry my hair while this sat. I would top it off with these two mixed together, and it was a beautiful combo, then with some sunscreen. I finished 2 of the Glossier Boy Brow, which is my favorite brow product in brown, my eyebrows. Love, love, love this product for my eyebrows. So that was everything that the products that I used up. Now for exciting Diptyque announcements. As you know, I shop at the Diptyque. Well, I don't shop physically there, but I shop on the phone there. At the Diptyque in Beverly Hills. This is a $70 candle exclusive to the Beverly Hills store, which is limited edition. Yes, it's a limited edition. What I am going to do is let you all know that I am making it. Well, I'm not making it. They are making it permanent. Yes. So it is no longer limited edition. It is a permanent permanent fragrance there. You still can only buy it there. You can't go online or anything, which is really, really exciting. I love that candle so much. They have one in Berlin as well, an exclusive, which I'm dying to get my hands on, and one in Miami. And to celebrate, and because I love all of you guys so much, this is the candle all wrapped up, and I am going to give it to one of you. Yes. So I am going to give it to one of you guys to win this amazing, amazing Diptyque Beverly Hills candle. All you have to do is like this video, subscribe to my channel, follow me on Instagram and Snapchat. All of those things will be down below. And leave a comment on this video. I know it's a lot, but this is a $70 candle that I'm giving away to one of you guys. So, really exciting. So, like this video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I will be checking on the winner. Let's see. Like this video, subscribe to my channel, follow me on Snapchat and Instagram, and leave a comment on this video telling me what products from here that you're dying to try, or what you want to try. Let me know. And or you've already tried. Favorite Diptyque, anything like that. Okay, guys, I'll talk to you later. Bye!